Good day to you, and welcome to Aristocards, featuring only the finest in tabletop card gaming. IKORIA Lair of Behemoths is nigh, and with it comes some enthralling new mechanics, quite relevant to the Commander format. Companion is an ability that states, if this card is your chosen companion, you may cast it once from outside the game. With it comes a stipulation or restriction in order to be said companion. Obosh, the Preypiercer, has the stipulation of your starting deck contains only cards with odd converted mana costs and land cards. For the Commander format, this means you can have your 100 card deck and one additional card, which is the companion. Therefore, you will essentially require 101 card sleeves. Allow for us to continue examining this card. For 3 and the hybrid mana symbols of red, black, red, black, Obosh the Preypiercer is a 3/5 legendary creature Hellion Horror. If a source you control with an odd converted mana cost would deal damage to a permanent or player, it deals double that damage to that permanent or player instead. This presents a compelling conundrum. Would Obosh the Preypiercer be good enough on his own merits to serve as the commander for a deck? Or is he better as a companion and therefore you are stuck with the restriction of only odd converted mana cost cards? Leveraging Obosh as the commander shall provide a rather straightforward strategy. We shall be endeavoring to deal as much damage to our opponents as possible. Let's first explore his uses as a commander, and then we shall explore his uses as a companion. The substance of a commander deck with Obosh at the helm will likely include cards such as Sizzle and Breath of Malfagor. Sizzle is a 3-cost sorcery that deals 3 damage to each opponent. Now, dealing 3 damage to each opponent in commander is nothing to write home about, but dealing 6 damage to each opponent for only 3 CMC is cause to raise an eyebrow. Similarly, with Breath of Malfagor, for 3 black red, it is an instant. Breath of Malfagor deals 5 damage to each opponent, and as it has an odd mana cost, Obosh will double this damage, dealing 10 damage to each opponent. And we are now off to the races. A card that seems perfectly fitted for Obosh is Chandra's Ignition. For 3 red-red, it is a sorcery. Target creature you control deals damage equal to its power to each other creature and each opponent. With Obosh's power of 3, and of course him doubling the damage, he now deals 6 damage to all other creatures and 6 damage to each opponent. Even a simple card such as Lightning Bolt shall perhaps find a place in an Obosh commander deck, as with him on the board, it shall now deal 6 damage to target creature or player. In addition to casting large spells after Obosh is on the board, we can be playing many enchantments on the battlefield to prepare for when Obosh comes into play and greatly increase their potency. Ancient Runes is an enchantment for 2 and a red. The Oracle text reads, at the beginning of each player's upkeep, Ancient Runes deals damage to that player equal to the number of artifacts they control. Now, eventually, this will harm us as well, but it will harm all of our opponents first. Spell Shock is also an enchantment for 2 and a red. Whenever a player casts a spell, Spell Shock deals 2 damage to that player. And believe you me, the combo decks out there will certainly become frazzled when you get Obosh on the board and now they are taking 4 damage whenever they cast a spell. Sulfuric Vortex states that at the beginning of each player's upkeep, Sulfuric Vortex deals 2 damage to that player. If a player would gain life, that player gains no life instead. However, red doesn't get to have all the fun. Black also has its share of enchantments. Underworld Dreams costs black, black, black. Whenever an opponent draws a card, Underworld Dreams deals 1 damage to that player. And if there's one thing that players in the Commander format love to do, it's draw many, many cards. And when Obosh hits the board and they start taking 2 damage for each card they draw, they'll be that much closer to joining Erebos in the underworld. There's a creature card I possess in my collection that I've been looking to find a home for, and I believe we've found it with Obosh. It's Lightning Reaver. For 3 black red, it is a 3/3 creature zombie beast. It has fear and haste. Whenever Lightning Reaver deals combat damage to a player, put a charge counter on it. At the end of your turn, Lightning Reaver deals damage equal to the number of charge counters on it to each opponent. As it possesses both fear and haste, it is quite likely that the Lightning Reaver shall deal combat damage on the turn that he comes into play. And with Obosh on the board, he shall deal double his combat damage, so he shall deal 6. Then at the end of the turn, he'll deal double the damage for the charge counters on him, dealing another 2 damage to each opponent. Even if he doesn't survive 2 subsequent turns, dealing 12 damage for 5 CMC is certainly nothing to turn up your nose at. And don't forget, Obosh will double the damage coming from cards of odd converted mana costs of any source you control. This also includes artifacts. Iron Maiden costs 3 generic mana. At the beginning of each opponent's upkeep, Iron Maiden deals X damage to that player, where X is the number of cards in their hand minus 4. And as we've previously stated, players in Commander enjoy drawing many, many cards. As we've now explored leveraging Obosh as your commander, allow for me to elucidate on the companion mechanic. In utilizing Obosh as the companion, we lose access to all cards with an even converted mana cost. I see the most significant impact of this restriction on the 2 mana cost mana rocks. We are now forbidden from using cards such as Arcane Signet, Rakdos Signet, and Felwar Stone. This significantly increases our reliance on 1 mana cost and 3 mana cost mana ramp. We must rely on cards such as our trusty Soul Ring, Mana Vault, and Dark Ritual. And in the 3 slot, we still have access to our Coalition Relic, Rakdos Clue Stone, and the ubiquitous Commander's Sphere. I have selected 5 legendary creatures that I believe would potentially benefit the most from Obosh being the companion. Now do remember, if we choose Obosh as the companion, even our commander must have an odd converted mana cost. The first commander is Kervek the Merciless. For 5 black red, it is a 5/4 legendary creature human shaman. The updated oracle text for Kervek reads, whenever an opponent casts a spell, Kervek the Merciless deals damage to any target equal to that spell's converted mana cost. The value proposition here is rather straightforward. Kervek the Merciless shall now deal double damage to any target as long as Obosh is on the battlefield. The second is Gyrus, Waker of Corpses. For X, black, red, green, it is a 0/0 legendary creature Hydra. Gyrus, Waker of Corpses enters the battlefield with a number of +1/+1 counters on it equal to the amount of mana spent to cast it. Whenever Gyrus attacks, you may exile target creature card with lesser power from your graveyard. If you do, create a token that's a copy of that card and that's tapped and attacking. Exile the token at the end of combat. Now, this is important. Creature tokens that are copies of cards also have the printed mana cost. Therefore, the token shall also benefit from the double damage provided by Obosh. And with Gyrus also dealing double damage, this could now be quite potentially a serious threat. I also like that if push comes to shove and Obosh dies, that Gyrus, Waker of Corpses, could potentially make a token copy of Obosh, at least for a turn. Our third commander is Nekusar the Mind Razor. For 2, blue, black, red, it is a 2/4 legendary creature zombie wizard. At the beginning of each player's draw step, that player draws an additional card. Whenever an opponent draws a card, Nekusar the Mind Razor deals 1 damage to that player. Now it's true, we lose access to a few cards such as Teferi's Puzzle Box, but we do retain access to that ever so important card Wheel of Fortune and a few other cards such as Memory Jar. Again, the value here is rather straightforward. Whenever an opponent draws a card, Nekusar the Mind Razor will now deal 2 damage to that player if Obosh is on the field. The fourth legendary creature is Vile Smasher the Fierce. For 1, black, red, it is a 2/3 legendary creature Goblin Berserker. Whenever you cast your first spell each turn, Vile Smasher the Fierce deals damage equal to that spell's converted mana cost to an opponent chosen at random, and it has partner. First of all, Obosh gives him a 5 CMC spell to deal 5 damage to a random opponent. And of course, when Obosh enters play, now all of the cards you cast are going to deal double the damage from Vile Smasher. And the commander that I believe benefits the most from Obosh potentially as a companion is Grevin, Predator Captain. For 3 black red, it is a 5/5 legendary creature human warrior. He has menace. Grevin Predator Captain gets plus X plus 0, where X is the amount of life you've lost this turn. Whenever Grevin attacks, you may sacrifice another creature. If you do, you draw cards equal to that creature's power, and you lose life equal to that creature's toughness. Grevin likes to sacrifice creatures that have extremely high strength, such as Ball Lightning. And to gain significant strength, he leverages cards such as Wall of Blood to lose significant life. In utilizing Wall of Blood's ability, we could lose 6 life to make Grevin an 11 power creature. However, if Obosh were also on the board, Grevin could now potentially deal 22 combat damage to a player. And in dealing at least 21 commander damage to a single player, it is now lights out. Also, in a pinch, if you were desperate to draw cards with Grevin and you had no other creatures on the board, you could use his ability to sacrifice Obosh. And just have a gander at these 2 fine specimens. Would you not state that it looks like they are long-lost friends? Oh, wizards, I do believe this is a golden opportunity. We should errata Grevin to also have partners with Obosh, and vice versa. I'm of course being a bit facetious, but Obosh serving as a companion will do for now. And now the time has come to hear your thoughts, commoners. Are you planning to utilize Obosh the Preypiercer as a commander? And if you're scheming to leverage him as a companion, which legendary creatures are you likely to pair him with? I do ever so enjoy reading and responding to your comments below. Please be sure to like and subscribe and share this video with your commoner friends. Until next time, cheers!